Hello and welcome again to BuilderBot. My name is Matt Farmer, here with you as always to help you get the most out of your Power Virtual Agents. Today in the session, we're going to be talking a bit more about custom analytics for those of you who want to extend and build on top of your Power Virtual Agents data. The first thing I will say is this is the second session we'll have done on custom analytics. We did one several months back. So if you want to know all about what custom analytics is PVA is about, I would highly recommend having a look at that session. Have a look in the link in the show notes below so you can get an idea of what we're talking about. But basically, to summarize, we have a solution that allows you to export all your data from Power Virtual Agents into Power BI. Well, why are people doing this? They want to share the success of their bot. So PVA has a great analytics solution within the PVA web toolset, but sometimes people want to take that and distribute it wider. They also want to be able to go and query it and do additional digging into that data to find out what their bots are doing. And they want to build that up in a simple and inexpensive way. And so the toolset that does that is available at the link below, PVA Analytics. You can go and deploy that to your PVA solution and build out the data pipeline to get this working. As I said, this is the second time we've gone through this. So we're going to go into a slightly more advanced topic in this one. The first thing I'm going to call out is something that's changed. And I know this perhaps isn't the most exciting screenshot, but the data in it really is. But this is something we added since doing that first recorded session. And this is a transcript viewer. This allows you to be able to view the actual contents of how people talked to your bot, and it's available in the PVA analytics solution. So if that's something that's really interesting to you, go to the link I showed, install the solution and try it out. When you do try out the solution, you're gonna need to know which version. And this is really what we're talking about today, because there are two versions of the report, and I'll explain why. The first version, and if you're just trying PVA out, or you have a small bot, is the perfect place to start, is the version that does a direct connection to your Dataverse instance. And it does that using the Power BI Dataverse connector. So you can go in, put in your instance name, put in your credentials, and instantly it will fill out the Power BI report with that custom analytics data. Now, the problem with that is there is a limit on the endpoint in Dataverse that, because Dataverse behind the scenes is a kind of a SQL server, and it has a tabular data streaming endpoint, but that has a specific limit of query size on it. Now, that's important for making sure that your Dataverse service maintains itself well, doesn't get hit by enormous queries, but in the case of extracting the analytics, that does put a limit on what we can do. So if you're in the region of 5,000 or so queries or to your bot or less per month, you should be under that 80 megabyte limit, and you can use the base report and set that up within a few minutes. If, however, and many of you are, you've got a Power Virtual Agent that's servicing many thousands of requests a month, then it's time to look at a slightly more robust and a bit more fully featured solution. And that is the high scale version. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. So the high scale version of the custom analytics report uses a few extra components to work. Rather than connecting directly to Dataverse, what we do is use a feature in Dataverse called Azure Synapse Link to export data to Azure Data Lake Storage. And then we consume that data with Power BI DataFlows to do the extract, transform, and load components that we need to be able to scale the data that's coming in from the bot. The bot produces quite a lot of data, and to start with, it's in JSON format, so we need to do a whole bunch of transformations. The other thing I'm going to call out right now, and we'll talk about this a little bit more as we go through, is there will be additional administration and maintenance that's required in the more complex solution, but then that's the trade-off with having a much higher scale limit on the data. So let's talk about how this works before I go and show you exactly what it looks like in Dataverse and in Power BI. A little diagram to help us understand here. So the normal report literally connects the Power BI report on the right to Dataverse and creates the report. What we're doing, and I'm going to show you in a minute, is a little bit more complicated. The bulk of the data that your bot generates is stored in what's called the conversation transcript table. Now you can go and have a look at this in your Dataverse instance. The conversation transcript table includes a couple of columns in it that are JSON format. And those contain the bulk of the data about what actions your bot performed, what is said, what your customer said to the bot, and things like scores that we assign to the AI that's going on when that conversation is happening. We need to get that data out and store it in a place for long-term storage that's low cost and effective. And Azure Data Lake provides that in that storage. We export that using the Azure Synapse link. So once we've exported that data, we then join it with the lookup data that we have, which is bot and bot component tables. And we bring those together into a low-code toolset called DataFlows. It's part of the Power BI suite, and it allows us to do some extract, transform and load ETL work in a low-code format using Power Query to generate the underlying tables that are in that JSON data. So you'll see here we have tables like session info, CSAT survey information, intent recognition, which is where all the AI scoring is put, tables that we generate from that JSON and make available to a Power BI report. Finally, those data flows can be consumed in Power BI. So let's take a look at the how the solution is stored and available to you and what it looks like when you go to deploy it and make it work for your Power Virtual Agent. So the first thing is just to remind you what this looks like in GitHub. This is where the solution is stored. It's an open source solution. So if you do want to contribute back, please do. When you come into the solution, the top level is where the base report, the direct connection report I talked about is stored. You're going to want to go and click here into the Dataflow version. And the Dataflow version here has the example I showed you earlier of how the data flowing works, as well as step-by-step instructions to set this up. First place we're going to go is into Power Apps to look at our Dataverse data. So here we are in the Dataverse Explorer and Power Apps portal. The three tables we care about here are chatbot, or bot, where we store the top level information about your bots. This will export all the bots in this environment. The chatbot subcomponent, which contains things like your topics. And then the one we're interested in now that we're going to export is conversation transcript. Now, to set this up, what we will need to do is export conversation transcript using Azure Synapse link. You see it up here. And what I've also done is I've already set up an Azure Data Lake storage endpoint for this data to be exported. I click there enable because I've already set it up. But what that would do is go through the process of setting up export for this conversation transcript table. If I go down here and look at Azure Synapse link on the left, I can look at the data store that I've already configured. I can see this particular storage location that I've set up and which tables are being exported. Now, this is my test environment, so I've only got conversation transcript, but this pattern can work for lots of your data in Dataverse if you want to be able to export it to a long-term store. One of the main reasons customers do this is the default retention period within Dataverse is 30 days. Obviously, you can extend that, but there may be additional costs to cover. So this is a low-cost way to create a long-term data store of your data. So what this will do now is it will be doing a regular export of data recorded into the conversation transcript table and exporting it out to Azure Data Lake Storage. I've got a storage account already set up here. So if I go in and have a look at the containers within the storage location, you'll see where this data manifests itself. So I have this container here. And in this container are assets that we use to be able to understand the data in the conversation transcript export. Now, this is in a standard format called the Common Data Model. Now, I won't go into this in this session, but you can look it up. What this means is there's a standard schema for the data exported in this format. And if I just go in and quickly look, you can see the different snapshots and different CSV files that are being exported here to this location. When we've got the data in this location, what do we do with it? The next step in the process is setting up data flows in Power BI. Now, I'm not going to completely go through this process right now because it's a little bit more involved, but there are full instructions in the GitHub location. Effectively, what we have here is three data flows. Now, the first one here is one that is connected. If I go and try and edit it, it won't let me because it's connected directly to the Azure Data Lake storage location. So if, for example, I go to new data flow, what I will see here is the option to attach a common data model folder. And that's how I've generated that data flow. What I do is attach that folder by pointing to the model.json file, and then the data in that location based on that model.json will appear in Power BI. So that's how I generated that first data flow. The next one that we care about is this PVA Analytics Export Transform. What this does, and again, the template for this is all in that GitHub location. You don't have to create it yourself. If I go into it, this is a Power Query job that generates those lower level tables based upon the data in the conversation transcript. So we export session info and intent recognition and all the others in this job running in your Power BI instance. So if I open up Power Query, you can look at how this contains all of the data that we need to build up these tables. And if, for example, if I bring up session info here, you can see the steps that are required to process the session info data. It may take a few seconds to actually bring up some data, but you can see that all the steps are there. Now, this is pre-created for you in the template file that is in the GitHub location. You don't have to generate it yourself. What you care about when you're using the data is that these tables are pre-created for you and you can import into your report. Now, one additional step here is there is an interstitial data flow. Now, there's a small bug in data flows at the moment that blocks me connecting this one to this one. That will be resolved at some point soon. But the moment, the instructions show how to use this interstitial step, which effectively copies the contents from here to another data flow. So we're chaining them together. I wouldn't worry too much about that. Again, that's a known issue that this works around. It will eventually be resolved. Once you've had those data flows set up, they're then consumed from a Power BI report. I showed you the Power BI desktop report in the previous session. This is what the Power BI desktop report looks like when it's saved to Power BI. There's a data set here, which is based on this data, and then the full report itself. So finally, this is the Power BI report as it was in desktop sitting in the Power BI service. Obviously, this is my demo instance, and we've got a very paltry two sessions running in my report. But this report is connected to those data flows. So all the data processing is happening in this Power BI workspace. You can set this up yourself, import and save your Power BI report here. The one thing I would call out that you need to do is set scheduled refresh. So you need to be able to say when these are actually going to be refreshed and imported. There are a few other steps that you just need to call out. The first one is that to use the data flows in this way does require a Power BI premium license. So check that you are able to use that at the moment. At the moment, you can see this diamond here. It's using the Power BI premium license. That can be a user-based license. Or a server-based license. There are plenty of guides online to show you how that works. The other thing is with the Dataverse location, you are building up a store here of all your data. There needs to be some consideration made into when this data will be archived so that it isn't pulled into the Power BI report and put in maybe a cold path or something like that. So there is more admin and thought work, but again, this will scale much, much higher than the base report. I hope you found that interesting. If you do have a PVA bot that is scaling to many thousands of users or thousands of sessions, and you're looking at a way to get your data out and share it with others, the custom analytics report is a great way to do that. It should save you a lot of time. There's just some considerations when we start to get to a really high scale that you need to factor in to build out a working solution. So I hope you found that useful. All the details of what I talked about today are detailed on the GitHub location. So that's aka.ms/PVA analytics. So please go in there and have a look. try it out. And if you find issues or suggestions or want to learn more about how it's working, then please put comments and raise issues on the GitHub location. Hope that's been useful. As always, please like and subscribe and leave comments in the chat below. I'll be back with another BuilderBot soon. Thanks for watching.